Hello, my name is Minas Kafatos. I'm a quantum physicist and practitioner of meditation, looking at the universe through the eyes of science, but also carrying a dialogue between science and spirituality. You may ask and wonder, why is a dialogue necessary? Actually, as human beings, we dialogue all the time. We dialogue with our families, with our friends, we're in relationships. It is the way we are, we human beings. Now, in fact, what I propose to you is that what comes out of the best of science, of quantum physics and cosmology, three fundamental laws of the universe, actually apply to every single thing that you do in life. Everything that you think, you work as an artist, you work as a practitioner of whatever practice you happen to follow, as a university professor, as a businessman, politician. These three laws are actually very simple, and they do apply to everyday life. First one is called the law of complementarity. Sometimes we know of it as the yin and the yang. The two aspects that are there all the time together, but they don't apply at the same time, okay? But they're together because one implies the other, the second. You can't have one without the other. As human beings, we're used to choosing one side. You say, well, I'm looking for hot, or I'm looking for cold, I'm looking for good or not so good, up or down. So this is actually what our mind does. Pursues yes or no. Complementarity says it is yes and or no. Okay? Second law is the law of universality or repetition. If you like, it is the law of structures across different scales. We call it, in scientific terms, recursion. For example, if you look at a tree, it has certain structure, right? All trees on Earth have some basic structures. They have roots, they have the stem or the plant, and of course, the leaves. And the leaves can be different shapes. Then the plants, or the trees, they connect to each other through the roots. Well, actually, in the human brain, you have a similar type of structures in the neurons. The neurons, in some ways, when you look at them, they remind us of trees. When you look at very distant galaxies, clusters of galaxies, we see them and we say, oh my goodness, this looks like a bunch of neurons. Now, we're not saying necessarily that these clusters of galaxies are a bunch of hundreds of millions of light years across neurons. But it is peculiar that this structure that we see at a particular level in the brain also applies to millions or hundreds of thousands of light years. The third law is also very familiar to us. It's called the law of flow. Flow. We always flow. We always are in move. In fact, our body is nothing more than a set, a large set, hundreds of millions or so of cells. Most of them, by the way, are not even our own cells. But leaving that aside, our body is a continuous flow of cells that interact together in a marvelous way. And when a little bit goes off, then you get disease. And some of these diseases can be life-threatening, because if you're way off, unbalanced, then the system suffers. These three laws, complementarity, recursion, and flow, apply everywhere. So the point here is to be aware of them and to feel and be part of a universal reality that you are as important as the next person. You are the center of the universe. You are the periphery of the universe. You are everywhere in the universe because you are part of these three laws, fundamental laws. And in terms of practicality, what this means is that we can experience the moment because these three laws apply all the time. When we say we experience the moment, I call that living the living presence. There is a presence. You are the presence. Your neighbor, your lover, your child is the presence. It's alive. And finally, you live that living presence every moment of your life. Thank you very much. Enjoy life. Enjoy your living presence.